dreams and they all started laughing. So hello guys, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Madison Scudieri. I have honestly not vlogged in so long, guys, so I'm so excited for today's video. I'm kind of just taking you through my day, and I have a little package I got, so I want to open that for you guys and show you all the pieces, and I'll show you guys how I kind of create content, and yeah, and we're also going to throw in a workout in today. I didn't ask for a free ride. I only asked you to show me a real good time. So first things first, with this video, I want to show you guys a package I received. I was like so excited, I could not believe it. I woke up one morning and I had actually a following and message from Heidi Summers. Buff Bunny, you guys know I'm a huge advocate of their clothes, The Mission, Heidi Yourself, Christian, everyone. I just love the two companies they run. So had a message from her, talked to her a little bit, and she ended up actually wanting to send me a care package. So basically it was just a PR package, this right here. Again, stoked to get it. It was like over the moon. Like, this is like unreal, guys. So got the package. I want to show you what's inside. So first, look how cute. Look how cute the box was. Okay. Change the game. What I received was, and I'm also going to show you guys all these pieces and what I think about them. And a video overlay, so bear with me. But I got these super cute, I think these are the Nubri fabric. Let me check. Yes, this is the Nubri jogger. So again, I've never gotten any of their joggers simply because I always feel like my body type sometimes like is very hard to put in clothes. So I'm kind of short, you know, my thighs are a little larger, I have hips, and it just like, I don't know, sometimes joggers never fit and they kind of look short on me. So I never really buy joggers. But I tried these on and I was pleasantly surprised how soft and actually form-fitting they were, but still flattering. And they have little side pockets that you can unzipper or zipper yourself. Little cinch. And then it came actually with the matching sports bra. And again, guys, I was super excited because I had never, I actually never bought the sports bra, but I do love how they design their square front tops. I have a few sports bras by them that have this same kind of square neckline, and I just think it's very flattering. And as always, the back is just so incredibly detailed. And these sets together, I think, are just awesome. Like, I always say, like, pieces are pieces, but when you have sets together that companies make and you try them on, they are like, I don't know, if they go together, they're just like, they make you feel so empowered and beautiful. Okay, so that was that. Next one, this cute little halter, kind of one shoulder. Again, I usually never go for these, so I'm happy they sent me them because I probably would have never bought this on my own. Personally, just working out with no side strap, I always feel like a boob might pop out on this side. So this would definitely be for like, I think, a lower body day, but so cute on. I love the little detail of like the sheerness on either side. And actually, you kind of can reverse it, I think, but the pads are on one side. But again, super cute. Also, guys, I am going to list my measurements and everything right here. I did get everything in a size small on the top, and on the bottom, I do a medium. I may be able to do a small in their bottoms, but I personally have never tried their bottoms in a small. Medium fits well. Sometimes there's a little fabric, like, up here. But personally, I'd rather be comfortable all around rather than, like, compression in some places and not others. So that's why I go with the mediums for the bottoms. Next, so this pattern had sold out when I was trying to originally get it, but I got it sent to me. So again, square frontline neck, okay, with the little, I think it's like a leafy or dot pattern. Again, Nubri fabric, okay, designed the back, gorgeous, same sports bra as the other one. And then on top of that, a matching biker short. Okay, love this pattern again. And guys, let's just like notice the detail on the back of these. Like, Buff Bunny Collection literally does such a good job of, like, contouring just to add accents, but also just make them more flattering. So, again, with this top and this back, I just think this set is, like, unbelievable. The detail on the contour of the butt and then the top sports bra, I just, again, love it. And then, again, I got sent these black leggings as well. Again, I'm never usually a girl who goes for pocket leggings. I did end up running a 5K a couple months ago with my boyfriend. And ironically, I've never been a runner, but when I started, I was like, oh, like maybe those like pockets could have helped in the leggings that I never buy. So actually really excited to try these and run in them so I can store my phone in the pocket. Super flattering. Love the material of this as well. And this is also the Nubri fabric. Definitely going to pair this one with the sports bra. Like, I love mixing and matching all my workout gear. Like, even sometimes I have to try to like plan out outfits because I always gravitate towards like blacks, neutrals, and blues. So I'm trying to venture out there. But again, this combo I think would be also adorable with the back. And so the next thing, I got this adorable rain jacket. So it's kind of like a windbreaker. Again, it's so cute. The detail, it has Buff Bunny written all down the, let me show you guys, all down the side of the jacket. It's super lightweight. It's one of those jackets where you can just kind of casually throw on, just if it's like a little hot out, but it's a little chilly or like windy or raining. And it's very lightweight, easy, and it's not too thick. So I also got this in a small and has a little hood. Again, guys, super cute throw on jacket. You can wear anytime, it's cold, warm, just something to throw on top of, you know, everything you're wearing. And then, last but not least, they sent me this tote. Guys, honestly, I've seen this tote so many times and I've honestly never splurged for it. This can be my new work bag because I do start work in person come January, a couple days a week, a little hybrid. So this is gonna be great. I'm gonna show you guys in the video, but it has a awesome like laptop compartment. It has little pockets for your phone, zippers inside. It totally closes as well, so that's really nice. And big, sturdy handles, and guys, get this. So literally, when I'm going to work, I'm just going to pack some cold lunch. And it has a little freezer, or refrigerated? I don't know, container for food, but you know the food goes here, okay? It'll keep it probably cold or warm, whatever you put in there, and it's just awesome because it's like a space where you don't have to throw it in your bag. When I used to meal prep, I used to throw my meals inside my bag for work, and it was fine, but it was like, I don't know, you just never want like your food where your bag stuff is, because God forbid it like spills or anything. But this, I just love the black. Again, I don't like venturing out and like going for colors, but this black is just so stunning. Okay, so that was everything I got from Buff Bunny. Again, so excited. I'm like eager to create content with these, so I am actually probably going to take you guys with me somewhere, I have no idea yet, to create some content in these pieces for Instagram. Again, Buff Bunny, thank you so much for sending me these pieces. It's like a dream, totally an honor. I am 2 years ago, like in Madison, be screaming right now, and I am now. I'm just can't believe like I got this package. So yeah, I will see you guys in a little bit. We're gonna go on the road. I'm gonna take some content and show you guys how that all works. Also, shout out to Hydrojug. I've honestly seen these. I'm sure everyone's seen these all over Instagram. All the fitness influencers have them. Honestly, I just love drinking water. I have my Hydro Flask. I'm like a diehard Hydro Flask fan, and they sent me this for free. And honestly, like, it's cute, guys. Like, if you have, I guess, not have a good water bottle and have trouble like drinking water throughout the day, definitely get one of these. People in like high school, for me, used to carry around like actual jugs. So I think that's where like this comes from, that you kind of still have like a water jug, but it's like your own personal one. And it comes with like a little strap and everything and this cool straw. So thank you, Hydrojug, again, for this product. And yeah, if you guys want to check it out, I do have a link below and a coupon code that you guys can use a discount to obviously support me. So thank you guys in advance if you do. Also, bunny, stop, Lola, stop. Okay. Also, just had to give a little shout out to my buns. I'm obsessed with them. They're my little babies. Lola's being a little, oh, this is Miles. Say hi, Miles. Hello. You're my little bun. This is my pretty little Loli girl. Say hi, Loli. See? Oh. This is kind of random, but I just wanted to also talk about this book that I've been reading lately, because I don't like fiction books. I like nonfiction books about like people's life stories and like, you know, things they go through, etc. This, oh, it's upside down. This book, Atomic Habits, it's by James Clear. Lately I've been struggling with like kind of figuring out how to like become motivated in a way that actually keeps me motivated. I consider myself someone who works out, right? So I would consider myself a fit person. Some people put themselves in a bubble and say, well, I'm not fit, I don't work out, I'm not that healthy. But why can't you be? So how do you start forming those habits to be that person? Like, I would say I'm not a big reader. Well, how can I change to make myself a reader? Does that mean waking up and reading more every day? Does that mean putting my phone down? You know, once we find out the identity of ourselves and what we want to become, it eliminates us from being saying, oh, I'm not that, I'm good at this but not that. If you start identifying yourself as a minimalist or a clean person or someone who's very tidy and organized, you have to practice those little habits every day that make you someone. And if you're not someone like that, ask yourself, what would someone who's super organized do in this situation? What would someone who's healthy do? Would they, you know, try to get all their macros in this meal or like go for like chips? Things like that, just little step-by-step things that I've been telling myself every day. Honestly, has helped, just improved of who I want to become, who I am currently, and how to keep those habits on track. Definitely give this one a read. So I am now going to shoot some content. I'm going to show you guys how I do that, kind of where I do that. My boyfriend had the nerve to ask me the other day, and I'm just kidding. He's like super, super supportive of my Instagram, which I love because I feel like maybe some people who you date might not be okay with you like posting all the time. I don't know, but he's a huge supporter of it. He asked me the other day why I always shoot in like places that are like industrial or like abandoned, and I'm like, well, like I'm by myself, so unless you're gonna come take pictures of me like in public in front of people, I have to take them myself. I have too much pride at the moment to go in front of like crowds with my tripod, so that's why I take them in industrial places. Also, just because sometimes my focal point is like the clothes in general, so I don't always want to like have like a busy background. So those flat kind of like nude backgrounds kind of make it pop. Okay, so I just finished. It's freaking cold. It's not actually that cold today. I've done like much worse. I just kind of leave my car running and like jump in, jump out, like how I'm feeling. I tried taking photos at like a bigger background with like the landscape. It didn't work out, so I ended up actually taking them right next to my car, in my car. And guys, the really cool thing is I use this app called Lens Buddy. It's like my basically tripod because I have no friends and family that want to take photos of me. It's fine, it's fine. I'm just kidding. But so basically it sets a timer and it lets you take photos at like rapid speed depending on like what you want. So that's kind of what I use. The front camera is definitely better than the back, or the back camera is definitely better than the front. I always hate it because like I wish there was a way for me like see how they look while I'm taking them so I can adjust, but it's kind of like a trial and error thing. But I will show you guys the finished product, and then I just like throw like a little like exposure and like contrast on them in Lightroom, and I just post them up, so you will see them very soon. I'm finally at the gym. I'm currently using this Veray gym bag that I got sent. I honestly have never tried Veray, but they gave me a credit for their store, and I got 3 bags, this duffel, which I actually do love. It has a super cool like shoe compartment, because like when I used to now I work from home, but like come January I'm gonna start working in office again. And when I used to work in Philly, I used to come from work and I always hated like having to change my shoes and like put them somewhere in my bag. So this actually has like a separate compartment for it, which is pretty cool because like you're not wearing sneakers to work. If you are, that's awesome and I'm jealous. Also in my gym bag I have my C4, guys. I'm a big advocate of pre-workout. I like it a lot, but it's up to you, it's personal preference. Again, don't like abuse it like anything. It motivates me more when I'm in the gym, but like everything, guys, like if you're not motivated already, don't think that adding something will make you more motivated. It's just supposed to get you in a pump for that mindset already. So like if you're studying, you take an energy drink, like you're gonna want to study more. If you're at the gym, you take an energy drink, you're gonna want to lift more, lift better, more focus. If you're sitting on the couch, you have an energy drink, your mindset isn't like, oh, I want to go work out right now because I had an energy drink. It's more like, well, I'm sitting on the couch and now I have a little more energy and I'm more focused on what I'm doing right now. So that's kind of my advice. Do not take it if you're not like motivated, because it won't like flip your motivation. It will just like enhance what you're feeling now. So get motivated, get in the gym, and then take it. If you've never taken it before, guys, don't take like the whole scoop, don't take the whole, you know, drink. Like if you're new to pre-workout, just start out like small. Personally, I like the feeling it gives me. Not everyone does, so it's just a preference for what you like. So yeah. All right guys, so I'm gonna take you through my workout. We're doing shoulders today, and I think a little bit of back. We're gonna see.
So same streets, same party, drowning their problems in Bacardi. Same people, still talking. Oh, I'm so worried, I'm sorry. Baby, you and me can leave right now. Ditch all your friends, the guy you came with. Get to know you where it ain't so loud. You and me alone, some old lonely road. But the two of us could disappear. Just say the word when you're out of here. Baby, you and me can leave right now. Meet me out back if you like how that sounds.
Okay, guys, so like usual, I always forget to like end these videos and like give a closing. Anyways, I got back from the gym, went and visited my grandma. Now I'm home, just gonna chill out, wrap some presents. And again, thank you guys so much for watching this video, and thank you so much for subscribing to my channel. If you haven't, click below and subscribe so you get notified every time I have new videos out. And again, thank you guys so much, and I'll see you next time.